Good morning, happy Sabbath. Thank you for joining us here at Sabbath Stream at the Washington Conference. You know, have you ever been asked to do a prayer and you don't know what to pray about? Like you totally forget? Yep, it happens to me too. But look, I'm gonna show you a technique in how to pray using your hand. So I'm gonna use this globe with different colors to show you how can we make a prayer. Okay, so these colors represent the different groups that we're gonna pray for. So this finger that is closest to you, it represents the people that live with you or interacts more with you. It can be your mom and dad. So don't forget, this finger is the one that closest to you and represents your mom and dad. Then we have this finger, that it's your pointing finger. This finger represents our teachers, our pastors, our nurses, and doctors. So please, they need your prayers. Don't forget about them. The next finger is the tallest finger. This finger represents our leaders. It can be our leaders in the government, business leaders, you know, those people that really make very tough decisions. So they need God. We need to pray for them. Then we have this finger that it's called our ring finger. This one is the weakest of all of them. So this finger represents our grandpas, our grandmas, our senior citizens that right now, if they're struggling, we need to pray for them. Then our little finger, it represents you. This little finger represents also that you have to pray for yourself. You have to pray for your spiritual life and for your growth in Jesus, okay? So now we have our fingers that represents five different groups that are very important to pray for. Remember, closest to you, teachers, nurses, and doctors, leaders in our government, senior citizens, our grandpas or grandmas, and yourself, okay? So now I'm gonna show you something super, super cool that you can do if you have Skittles at home. If you see this plate, they have a lot of colors, and those are the same colors as the groups that we're gonna pray for, okay? So now, if you have Skittles, go and get them and put them in this, in a circle, because we're gonna do something super, super cool. And you'll see the power of prayer right with Skittles. So then you're gonna get some hot water and you're gonna put it on the plate. And this is gonna take a little bit. So what I'm gonna ask you right now is to go on your knees right now here in your living room and we are going to pray, okay? So let's do it right now. Let's put our hands together and let's pray together, okay? Dear Jesus, thank you for being an amazing Father and taking care of us. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to talk with you through prayer. We love talking with you any time of the day. Dear Jesus, at this moment, we want to pray for our families. Please keep them safe from illness and from any danger. Please help all the nurses, doctors, pastors, and teachers at this moment that they need strength and wisdom from you. Dear Jesus, we also want to pray for the leaders of the government, leaders in business and industry, and administrators, Lord. These people shape our nation and guide public opinion. They need your guidance, Lord. Also, we want to pray for our grandparents and people that are older. Please, Lord, help them during this time of pain and discomfort. And last, Lord, I want to pray for me, for ourselves, for our kids. Lord, please help me to follow your steps always. Please help me to be a kind servant. And thank you, Father, for listening to my prayer. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Isn't that amazing that we can use our hand to pray, right? To remind us of five different groups that they're super, super important. Now, I want you to look at the plate and look how beautiful the colors are. It's amazing. And you know, this is a representation of prayer. When we pray, prayer unites us. And this is how beautiful it looks when we're praying for others. You know, right now, I invite you to use this technique and pray for these five different groups that they need your prayer. And I want to show you, I want to teach you a Bible verse that it's in Matthew 21, 22. And I want you to repeat it with me. Whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith. Matthew 21, 22. One more time. And whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith. Matthew 21, 22. One last time. And whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith. Matthew 21, 22. Please use this technique when you pray. May God bless you and have a wonderful Sabbath. See you next week.